Giants in the South Americas. First mention of these people came from the voyage of Ferdinand Magellan and his crew, who claimed to have seen them while exploring the coastline of South America en route to their circumnavigation of the world in the 1520s. Antonio Pigafetta, one of the expedition's few survivors and the chronicler of Magellan's expedition, wrote in his account about their encounter with natives twice a normal person's height. He states, "One day we suddenly saw a man of giant stature on the shore of the port, dancing, singing, and throwing dust on his head. The Captain General sent one of our men to the giant so that he might perform the same actions as a sign of peace. Having done that, the man led the giant to an inlet where the Captain General was waiting. When the giant was in the Captain General's and our presence, he marveled greatly and made signs with one finger raised upward, believing that we had come from the sky. He was so tall that we reached only to his waist, and he was well proportioned." Pigafetta also recorded that Magellan had bestowed onto these people the name Patagio, or Patagonai, in the Italian plural sense. Due to Pigafetta's recorded accounts of Ferdinand Magellan's experiences on the island, the assumption was that this word, Patagio, was derived from the word pata, or foot, and the Patagonia was interpreted to mean land of the big feet. The name Patagonia stuck, as did the notion that the local inhabitants were giants. Early maps of the New World afterwards would sometimes attach labels entitled Regio Gigantum to the area, which means region of giants. In 1579, Sir Francis Drake's ship chaplain, Francis Fletcher, wrote about meeting very tall Patagonians. In the 1590s, Anthony Nivet claimed he had seen dead bodies 12 feet long in Patagonia. Also, in the 1590s, William Adams, an Englishman aboard a Dutch ship rounding Tierra del Fuego, reported a violent encounter between his ship's crew and unnaturally tall natives. In 1766, a rumor leaked out upon their return to Britain that the crew of HMS Dolphin, captained by Commodore John Byron, had seen a tribe of 9-foot-tall natives in Patagonia when they passed by there on their circumnavigation of the globe. Sebald de Weert, born 1567, died 1603, was a Dutch captain associated with the exploration of the coasts of South America and the Falkland Islands south of Argentina. De Weert and several crew claim to have seen members of a race of giants while there. De Weert described a particular incident when he was with his men in boats rowing to an island in the Magellan Strait. The Dutch claimed to have seen 7 odd-looking boats approaching, which were full of naked giants. These giants supposedly had long hair and reddish-brown skin and were aggressive toward the crew. The Dutch claimed to have shot 3 of these giants dead with their muskets before the giants finally retreated to the shore. De Weerts claims the sightings of giants were not totally unusual for this region, as Magellan also first recorded sightings in the 1520s in the Straits of San Julian. It was also claimed that Magellan captured 2 male giants as specimens to return to Europe, but the giants died en route. These creatures were supposedly well over 9 feet tall. Many others, including Francis Drake, Pedro Sarmiento, Tomé Hernández, and Anthony Nivet, claimed to have seen giants in the Straits of Magellan. With the last sighting having been at Cabos Virgins in 1764 by Commodore John Foulweather Jack Byron. De Weerts' expedition is the only one to have claimed to have witnessed aggressive behavior on behalf of the giants. Don't forget to watch, like, and share Bigfoot in the Forest on all your social media. Bigfoot in the Forest can be found on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Pinterest, and Reddit.